What's up, guys? This is your girl, Lady Steel, coming at you with another video. Week 9, hate week against the Indianapolis Colts. Now, let me say this. Indianapolis Colts fans, if you think that this win is going to be a walk in the park, you are sadly mistaken. You are sadly mistaken. The Steelers are 3-4. Do not let our record fool you. Okay. Do not let our record fool you. Let's state some facts real quick. The Steelers are over the Indianapolis Colts in the overall series 24-6. 24-6. Okay. The Indianapolis Colts have not beaten us at home since 2008. Over 10 years. In the last 8 matchups, we've won 6. We have owned the Indianapolis Colts in the recent years. As a matter of fact, we own the Indianapolis Colts, period, especially at home. So please, do not underestimate the Steelers, because that would be the worst mistake. If you think that you're going to come into Heinz Field and have an easy win over us, you better have several seats. Now, I must admit, Jacoby Brissett, he's good. He can run and he can throw. But let's see how he does against the Steelers defense. Let's see how he does against our front 7, who's a sacking machine. Let's see how he does against a good defense that can generate turnovers. Let's see about that. If we get to the quarterback and generate turnovers, we should have no problem with this team. No problem at all. Now let's look at the Indianapolis Colts. They're 5-2. That's a good record. But look at the two teams that they lost to. They lost to the Oakland Raiders and the LA Chargers. Wow. Is this a example of a good team playing down a competition? Sort of kind of, you know, what the Steelers do. But the difference is the Steelers are at home, where we own the Indianapolis Colts, and the Indianapolis Colts tend to play down the competition. That's a recipe for the Steelers to win. On offense, the Steelers have a very good O-line. If we establish a run game and we get our receivers going, we convert on third downs, and we have good scoring when it comes in the red zone, we should have no problem with this team. Period. The Indianapolis Colts are kind of overrated to me. Yeah, they're 5-2. But let's just see what happens. The Steelers got to play mistake-free football. Randy Fickner has to have a good game. No stupid play calling. Set your players up in the positions to succeed. We seen last game that Juju Smith-Schuster is very, very good in the slot. How about we put Juju in the slot more? Put our faster receivers on the outside. And we should have some success. Juju had his 100-yard game. That's good. You know, some of you Indianapolis fans might say, you know, the Steelers are injury prone. Indianapolis is injury prone too. So you really can't talk. Okay. If the Steelers do what they need to do, then we should have no problem in our hometown beating an Indianapolis Colts who we own at home. We should have no problem. We can get to Jacoby Brissett. Don't let him scramble. You let him scramble, you might be in trouble. Contain him. Force him to throw. And let's see how his arm do. T.Y. Hilton, we got to contain him, which I believe we will. Their tight ends, we got to contain them, which I believe we will. You know, we do tend to come rusty off of bye weeks, which was proven against the Miami Dolphins. We shook off that rust, and now we're going to be right back into action. Indianapolis don't got nothing. They don't got nothing. Yeah, they're 5-2. But they're coming into a stadium where they are owned merciless. Period. They are owned. So what they gonna do? Absolutely nothing. The Steelers, we got this. We're gonna have this dub. Indianapolis, you're going down, and you're going down hard. Shout out to the Steelers. Shout out to Steeler Nation. Get ready. Go Steelers. We're about to get this dub. This is your girl, Lady Steel, coming at you with another video. Go Steelers. Peace.